Hi, and welcome to the Microsoft Virtual Academy. We're focusing here in this session on the 20 C-sharp questions explained. My name is Jerry O'Brien. I'm joined by Paul Party. We're counting down. We're getting close to the end here. We're working on question number 19 of the top 20 questions that programmers ask around C-sharp and how to do things that they specifically have issues or problems with in their coding. So number 19, we have somebody who had asked a question on how do I sort a dictionary by the value that's in the dictionary itself. So the interesting aspect of dictionary collections are that we deal with dictionaries as a key value pair. So that's the type of collection that a dictionary is. And if you think about it from the perspective of a real dictionary that you would look up, we have key values. So the key is the word that you would look up in the dictionary, the value being the definition. So a dictionary collection in a programming language is similar. We have a key that points you to a value, and then you have a value that's representative of whatever it is that you want to store within that. For the most part, when you're sorting dictionary objects, it usually ends up being sorted by the key, not by the value. So how do we sort it by the value becomes a bit of a coding problem that somebody wants to know how to solve. And we're going to, like in the previous question on question 18 that we had about removing duplicates, we're going to step back and rely on link language integrity. I can't even say that now after I give Paul a hard time in question number 18. I can't even pronounce it anymore. So link is language integrated query, which is a feature of the language that was added in C# a couple of versions ago. So link will allow us to write a query within our language, within C#, and then basically take the objects, sort them, and put them into a new object for us to use. So let's pop into Visual Studio, and we'll see how this works. So what we've created here is, this is a method called sort dictionary, and within sort dictionary we are going to have a dictionary collection that has some values, and you can see that we have them completely out of order. So this is the key, 3152, and this is our value. 3152 is a textual representation. That could be your values, could be anything that you wanted to have in here for the dictionary. In our case, we're utilizing a generic dictionary collection, in which case it's strongly typed and we're expecting string values in our dictionary itself. So the values are specifically, they're out of order on purpose because we want to actually sort it and we want to order the dictionary values themselves. And you might normally pass in a dictionary into this method, but we've just included everything in here for the sake of completeness and shortness. And we're going to go through the process of sorting the dictionary items and then putting them into a list object. Now this list object will create a strongly typed list of key value pairs of string types, and we call it sort list. And then we're going to take the dictionary object that we have called diction, and we're going to convert it to list. Now, if you're familiar with lists a little bit and you're looking at a generic list and you're thinking, well, wait a minute now, doesn't a list only support like one value? How are we getting two in? The key is this aspect here is that we're using a key value pair. So we're allowing the dictionary key value strongly typed objects to fit into our list as a key value pair as opposed to a single entry in the list itself. So that's how we're getting the multiple values. And then we're going to use link. Var is used a lot in link, and var is just a way of saying this is a variable and can be of any type. So, it's sort of just going to take whatever type is appropriate based on what the language determines it needs to be. If you're coming from JavaScript, var becomes, I think, very familiar to a lot of JavaScript developers as well. So our link query is what does the work for us here in this particular instance. And so it says from entry, so we have to look at what an entry is. And in this case, entry is not listed anywhere in our code, but entry is a value in the dictionary. So for each entry in the dictionary, I want to order the values by entry.value. So in other words, the value, not the key. And I want to order it ascending. So that means alphabetically A to Z or numerically 1 to 2. It's ascending. And then we're going to select entry. If you've never actually seen link in action, if you've never actually written a link query, you might look at it and go, hey, that looks a little bit like SQL, but backwards. And it kind of is in a sense. So instead of putting the, like in an SQL statement, we would put select entry from entry in diction or what have you, and link does it a little bit backwards, but we think it's backwards. If you actually look at the logic behind SQL and especially Transact SQL, if you're focusing on SQL Server and Transact SQL, if you look at the query processing engine in the background, the query processing engine really executes the from first, and the select becomes the very last component that gets executed. So this is basically saying, I want to do something, but I got to tell you where to get the information from first. So that's why from comes at the beginning of the statement and select becomes at the end of the statement. So we're saying from a specific location or source, I want you to do something with values, and then I want you to select those values and manipulate them according to how we say. So thanks to Paul, who in question number 18 discovered our subtle little output issue that we ran into. I remembered to put the breakpoint in this time because we're not doing a console dot write line. So we'll rely on the debugging steps in this one to see what's actually taking place. So let's go ahead and execute this code. We click on start, and our console window went away, and that's perfectly fine because what we want to do is we want to focus on the values here. So we already know that if we look at, you know, diction, which is our dictionary object, and we were to expand this, we don't really even have to look at this because we know that these are not in a sorted way. It's 3152. That's the way we created it. But we did go ahead and we created this sorted variable, which is a list of key value pairs. And because of the link query that we executed, if we look at sorted, actually, let's not look at it from, wait, now we can get into sorted base, and I'm missing my values. I wanted to see how they were actually sorted in the value itself. Why can't I see that? Sorry,
it was the
results view. I knew I was missing something simple. So if we look in the results view, we see that we have 0123, and then we have 5132. Now, before you jump on the phone or fire off an email and say, you're completely out to lunch, this is not ordered by value. It is. It's ordered by value alphabetically. And the first time I ran the code, I looked at it and I thought, no, that didn't work correctly. Alphabetically, the letter F comes before the letter O, which comes before the letter T. So the values are sorted alphabetically correctly in ascending order, right? So we're not trying to get a numeric order here. We did sort the actual value by the value in the dictionary itself. All right? Quick and simple. That's how we sort a dictionary. We unfortunately have to throw it into another object, in which case we put this one into a list of key value pairs. But we were able to successfully sort it. Now, having said that, note that going into the .NET framework and looking at some of the other classes and the other features and functionality of the .NET framework, we do have sorted lists, and we do have sorted dictionaries. But again, evaluate those collections to determine whether they're sorting and what you want them to sort by. Most of them will sort by key, not by value. So be careful when you're using them to ensure you're implementing the right collection for your needs. So.
Yeah, and link does give you a little bit less control because it's essentially a single line of code that will operate against that whole collection. So if you need a little bit more control, you'll want to do for each loops and other types of methods to do that kind of sorting. But link is really efficient. It's easy to read. It's written more in natural language, and it's fast. So it's a good approach if all you need to do is sort.
Yeah, definitely. Good stuff.